Palomino, congratulations on your victory. You made it look very easy against Jim Ehlers. At one point, Jim Ehlers, it seemed like he was considered the poster child of bare knuckle fighting, and you kind of put that to the rest.
Yeah, well, you know, he was until I signed. The moment that I signed, I knew in my heart, I knew in my mind that it was over because I am the better fighter. You know, I keep growing, I keep learning, I keep evolving. I have the best team I've ever had in my life. So, you know, it was only a matter of time of proving it. Come here, man.
Right now we're seeing Jim Ehlers and Luis Baboon Palomino shaking hands after the fight, showing the respect with both fighters, both former teammates, but showing the camaraderie before between both of these competitors. Palomino, if you could share some of the comments there. Yeah, so you just shared some comments there with your former teammate, Jim Ehlers. Can you let us know what happened there?
Well, it is what it is. It's like I said, the moment that I signed, I knew that I would be the best fighter on the roster. I knew that it only took a matter of time until I can prove myself, and I did. And Jim was right all along about one thing, and that was, without beating him, this belt really didn't have value because he was the 4-0 with 3 knockouts. You know, he was the one that was like tearing through the division. So I had to take him out, and I had to do it in this fashion. I had to show how much better I really am. You know, it's not just cockiness or anything. It's my pure confidence, and it's the truth. You know, I am that much better, and I'm now here holding 3 belts.
You know, you've had so much accomplishments in your career, mixed martial arts. You've won a ton of belts from so many promotions, but where would you rank this one right now? Where would you rank this victory, this belt right now in your career?
This is definitely number one for me. This is the biggest one for me because at this age where most people were like, you know, oh, time is running out, you're old, I don't know what, you know, and MMA was a good phase of my life, but I started hard. I started bad. I had no wrestling skills, I didn't even wrestle in high school or college like most people did. I grappled for like 6 months and went straight to my pro fight, fighting 170 pounders. You know, I made all the mistakes you can possibly make, and I hurt my record. And now it's like I start all over again in what I'm really, really impressive at, you know, which is boxing, you know, trading hands. And, you know, boxing was my first love, but I couldn't become a boxer. Like, I was too old. Like, they wouldn't give me a fight. You know, I was training with Coach Dino. Do you know how long we were? We were training for like 8 months looking for a fight, and nobody would take the fight. Nobody would take it because why would it take a fight against a 39-year-old man that can knock somebody out? You know, so I understood that. And then bare knuckle surfaced. I took very big interest into it because the moment that you know, we came into this, it's like, okay, now we can box without the gloves, just like I did back in the days. And it's big. This show is going to be the biggest combat sports in the world, man. Forbes is already talking about it left and right.
So it seems now that you will become the poster child of bare knuckle fighting because you are the champion. You hold the prestigious belt. What is next for you? Is there a certain someone that you would like to challenge?
Look, there was a clown today. I don't know why he was allowed in the square circle. I think it was very disrespectful that he was even allowed to come into the square circle and steal the moment that I've been working my ass off for. I think it was very disrespectful. I'm not even going to name him. He's a nobody, man. I don't want to fight a nobody. I want to fight the biggest name possible that you can bring to me. I'm the biggest name in boxing, the biggest name in MMA, UFC, ONE FC, Bellator, you name it. But the biggest name, the biggest fame, bring that guy to me. Masvidal wants a rematch? Bring him over here to me. Maybe Nate Diaz wants to come in and take a swing at this. You know, whoever has a big name, a big following that's going to help the sport grow, that's what I want. Not some nobody with some tight pants, man. Get the fuck out of here with that shit.
So, Palomino, there is another former UFC veteran in bare knuckle fighting, which is Thiago Alves. Of course, he's a little higher in weight. Would you consider going up the weight class and take on Alves?
Look, we're gonna speak the truth here, okay? This is the truth. There's no disrespect here, okay? Ask Dave Feldman, who I asked for when he got signed, okay? And it's not in no disrespectful form. A very, very long time ago when I first started MMA, Thiago Alves kicked the crap out of my leg. And it was like the first time I ever sparred with a pro fighter, and he was a 170-pounder. I was fighting at 150, 155. And it was painful, and that pain was what helped me start using low kicks. And I won 70% of my low kicks with my calf kick that everybody's using now, that it originated from me. I have video proof, right? And I won 70% of my fights with the low kicks. And that was thanks to Thiago Alves, right? I'm a big fan of Thiago. He's a good friend, you know, from afar, from different camps. But when I heard that he was signed, I told Feldman, hey, Feldman, if his fight falls off, if you need a replacement for an opponent for him, I will take the fight. I will go up and wait, and I'll take the fight. Wasn't that true, coach? Eso no fue verdad. That's the truth. If that's not meant with any type of disrespect, it's because I respect him so much, because I'm a fan of him, because I've been watching him since way back, and he's younger than me, you know? So I said, man, you know, maybe we can do it. And, you know, like Jim was a good friend too. So, you know, I asked for that fight. So to answer your question, that would be a great fight. And if there was to be a title involved in a higher weight division, I'll go up just to fight him. You know, with all due respect.
So bare knuckle fighting, Forbes wrote an article that they're expanding their reach. Where do we see Palomino right now? Do we see Palomino perhaps finally fighting in Peru? In South America or in Russia, as some of the places they've been talked about that they've been visiting?
Man, I would love to take bare knuckle, not only to Peru, but to Japan, right? Japan, man, you know, bare knuckle, it's huge. It's huge over there. Like, they would, like, Pride. I mean, remember Pride, you know, until Pride sold to UFC. You know what I mean? Hey, Chuchu, shut your ass up for a minute. Anyway, so, you know, I would love to take it to Peru. I would love to take it to Japan. You know, and I would like to travel the world with it. You know, I'm there. I'm sign me up. Let's go. Let's go to Thailand. Let's go to Russia. I would love to fight some of those Russians I lost close decisions to over there. Over, like, taking me down and holding me and whispering in my ear, please don't hit me anymore. You know what I'm saying? Like, like, give me some of those. I'm down. I'm ready.
So you look fresh. You look clean. When can we see you back in action again?
Send the contract, and then we'll give you the date.